Look at this. The camera head is attached to this Raspberry Pi 5 board and a 3.5 inch display is also attached. The video coming from the camera is displayed directly on the screen. There are lots of camera modules and USB cameras for Raspberry Pi, but this is an AI camera that provides more functions than a typical camera module. Today, I'm gonna look at some of the things we can do in a system using this camera module. This is Raspberry Pi 5. It's 8 gigs. The SD card is using 256 gigabyte. Nothing special. This is an AI camera called PiNSIGHT, released by Arducam. I don't know how to pronounce it. PiNSIGHT or PiNSIGHT. I don't know. As you can see, it uses Luxonis SOM module. The structure includes a 4K IMX camera sensor on top of it. What's interesting is the camera cover. The heatsink size is crazy. I really like the heatsink that covers the entire camera. Luxonis has already created the DepthAI SDK to help developers easily build the system. You will love the examples provided here. Connects to the Raspberry Pi through a USB 3.0 interface. The size is perfect as it was made for the Raspberry Pi. The display is also made for Raspberry Pi, so it's a perfect fit. Now let me connect the power. The current OS is a Raspberry Pi Bookworm installed. Starting with Raspberry Pi 5, the use of Debian 12 is officially recommended. The screen on the left is for recording the Raspberry Pi with my iPhone. On the right is a VNC client mirroring the Raspberry Pi's screen. So you can see the screen being output on the Raspberry Pi screen more clearly. This is a basic demo of DepthAI. You can check color capture, neural network input, and FPS. This is a basic object detection. However, it does not capture all objects well. Sometimes objects are missed or not recognized at all. I think it would be good to just use this to check the basic operation of the camera. Why not try YOLO? It shows much better performance than the object tracking in the previous demo. It is fast and shows excellent performance, making different to find missed objects. If you need a different version of YOLO, you can also create one based on your own model. This can be very useful, so please take a look at this page. What about streaming? Not only RTSP streaming and WebRTC streaming, but also MJPEG streaming via HTTP can be easily established. High quality images can be transferred to connected clients very quickly. You can use the streaming function very easily as it is already provided through experiment examples. This test is to see how long it actually takes to draw an image frame on an HDMI connected display. There is no doubt that after capturing an image from a camera, completing the image frame in memory is very fast. I just wanted to find out how long it takes for data transferred from the camera to the USB interface to be output on a screen connected to HDMI. The resolution of the 3.5 inch HDMI display is 1920 by 1080. As a result of the test, it seems to take approximately 150 milliseconds. Of course, it's updating at 30 frames per second. This was actually tested to see how long it takes from end to end. Sorry, I can't show all the examples, but there are a lot of really great example sources. It's a very good starting point to run how we can make it. This is RayNet for detecting rains on the road. The size of the input video is 512 by 256 and the inference speed is around 2 to 4 FPS. Also, the right one is a car detection demo. It's using YOLO version 4 Tiny. Detecting people also works well. It's based on mobile LED. Arducam's new camera is an AI camera made for Raspberry Pi. Not only you can capture very high quality images, but you can also develop applications based on DepthAI's excellent SDK. Personally, I really like it. However, this is a single RGB camera. Therefore, It cannot be used in applications that require depth. For instance, it is not possible to obtain a three-dimensional object or generate data such as a point cloud. In this case, it's recommended to use a device such as a OctiSeries. This can be very useful because it has one RGB camera and stereo pair cameras together to calculate the depth. I believe you can easily start developing applications based on the useful SDK and API provided by DepthAI. Alright, that's it for today. Thanks for watching. See you on the next project.